Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to this video, which is a continuation of the video that I shot yesterday detailing my proof of concept idea for an audio coupled device to give you better synchronization when you're using an external recorder for cameras that don't have a mic input. Now, I've worked on this over the last couple of hours and found that really I can't improve the audio quality by improving the earbuds themselves, or I've used a small speaker and separated that away from the inputs of the mics, but I just can't get that nice crisp audio that you really want for your audio recording. But I am convinced this is a good idea to give you a much cleaner audio track in camera so you can synchronize your external recorder to it. And also my electronic clapperboard idea that gives you the visual and audio synchronization, and it's much better than clapping your hands together or a clapperboard. It gives you that nice synchronization to use in your video production. So really, I've taken this idea as far as I possibly can, so it's not something that I'm going to develop any further, unless anyone's got any better ideas of coupling that audio into the camera through the mic ports to give you a better feed. Of course, if you've got a camera with a mic input, you could use the output from your recorder and feed it into the mic input, and that will give you a much cleaner signal for your synchronization in post-edit. But if your camera doesn't have a mic input, this is an ideal way of getting that cleaner audio into a camera. At this sort of distance, over 20 feet, the internal mics aren't going to pick up very much, and especially if there's a wind around, that is going to obliterate your audio track. So this feeding directly into the mic port of the camera is going to give you a much cleaner signal to synchronize with your external recorder that you're going to be using to get the better audio. So this is how I synced today's video, by using that external recorder to the very good track that's been laid down by that acoustic coupler device on my camera mic port. Someone else was asking, what is the correct bit rate for using an external recorder if you wanted to record audio separately? Well, a lot of these audio recorders either allow you to do 44.1 kHz or 48 kHz. The 44.1 is the standard if you're going to be using it for compact discs, DVDs, that sort of thing. But if you're recording for video, you need to be using a bitrate of 48 kilobits per second. And that divides down nicely to give you the 25 or 30 frames per second video interval, so you don't lose lip synchronization over an extended period of time. So if you are going to use an external recorder, switch to 48 kilohertz bitrate, and then you'll find that you get much better synchronization over a longer period of time. So that's basically all I wanted to add to yesterday's video. So thanks again for watching, and if you are a new viewer, please do click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon to get a notification of when I upload new videos to the channel. Now, the rest of full details of how I've constructed this in the Tech Talk latest page of my photographic blog. I'll put a link to that in the video description below if you wanted to check that out. While you're there, check out the homepage. There's an application to join the 3-weekly newsletter group. That goes out to 2,800 people now, and it's a full technical publication in many respects, not just a newsletter. So if you want to receive that, just fill out that notification page. It allows me the authority to email you with that newsletter. So that's it for the video. As usual, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.